Welcome to another FiddleHed fiddle lesson. Gonna now show you the pentatonic scale on the violin or the fiddle, whatever you prefer to call it. It's a really beautiful scale. I love the way it sounds. Doesn't it sound sort of Japanese to you? It's also the basis of something called the blues scale. So, we won't do that today, but in a future lesson we will. So, in a nutshell, the pentatonic scale is a great way to break into improvisation. I want to start doing lessons on that. Improvisation for the violin or the fiddle, whatever you prefer to call it. Okay? It's also really good to have in your fingers because it's used a ton in certain songs. If you're really good at this, it'll help you pick up certain tunes better. Like there's one that I teach all the time called Kesh Jig, which is almost all G pentatonic. So point is, there's lots of uses for it. It'll improve your ear, pick up tunes better, learn to improvise. Now let's do it. Let's just do it. Okay, enough talk. I'm still talking. Enough talk. Still talking. All right, let's go to the open G. That's the first note of the pentatonic. I think you could do that. Okay, let's do a little bit more. Open 1-2 on G. Another great thing about it is that it's not that complicated. You're already 3/5 of the way there. You don't even have to know that much math to know that. And now just two more notes on D, open 1. So here's the whole thing. Let me give you a better angle now on the left hand. A little bit better angle. There you go, you know it. Done. You know the pentatonic scale. The rest is variations on that. It's true. If you can do this, then you can figure out all the other pentatonics. This is just a beautiful key to getting more out of music, enjoying music more. It's just so lovely what you're gonna be able to do with this. Okay, now go backwards. Don't forget to enjoy the sound. So nice. Try it with a bowing variation. Like, how about just two bows? All right, how about triplets? To sort of repeat on it. You could do the first finger twice at the top or... All right, so that's G pentatonic. Now we're gonna do D pentatonic. Before I show it to you, I want you to try to figure it out. Maybe you don't have to pause the video, or maybe you could pause it. I'm gonna give you another moment. Figure out the D pentatonic. It works in an analogous way to what we just did. All right? Do you figure it out? If not, pause it and try a little bit more on your own because you can figure it out, I think. Okay, bam, you're back. Welcome back. I'm now gonna just show it to you, okay? Are you sure you want me to show it to you? Okay, here it goes. So it's the same fingering, but it starts on open D. Now for sure you can figure out the A major pentatonic. So do that right now. If you may want to pause, play it a bunch. I'm going to now show it to you though. Let's do it with hoedown. All day. Okay, we're now going to go back to the G major pentatonic scale. And what we're going to do now is do it in two octaves. Okay, you ready for this? So first do the first octave that you know. So the next octave is going to begin on D3, which is a G note. Just play that. Get it in your ear, enjoy the sound. Okay, now we're going to walk up to the A. Open, 1, 3 on A. Even that's really pretty and nice. Ah, but we get one more beautiful note, the open E. If you know your pinky finger or fourth finger, you can use that. Now let's put it together with the lower octave. Two bows. Very good. Okay. Now, since we did that two octave version of the G pentatonic, let's do the D major pentatonic. It'll be the exact same fingering. We'll land on fourth on E. Let's just do it with two bows. That's the D major pentatonic. Back to G major pentatonic. Go up, but don't go down. So now I'm going to add three more notes. So we'll roughly have 2.5 octaves of this. We're going to go. Okay. So I began it. I didn't finish it because that will require third position. Actually, fourth position. So if you do already know those higher positions, you could go higher. I don't recommend it if you're intermediate or beginner level. Your beginner can do this scale, but I wouldn't recommend for beginners to be doing this yet. So the notes again we added to the two octaves of G major scale are. It's basically the first notes of the scale starting over. And to finish it, we need to go higher. But we won't. So if we put those three on with the other, with the first two octaves, this is what we get. Okay, and then, so we have the G, roughly 2.5 octaves, D, 2 octaves. Let's see, let's go back to the D. So we can extend the D, actually, the other direction down to the G string. All right, so these are the last two notes of the scale. And you can add those on to this. So the full range of the D pentatonic in this position down here, first position is. I'll do it with two bows. The last one I'm going to give you is A major pentatonic again, which was, remember, we start on open A. So we're basically going to do this an octave lower, starting first on G. Then adding 1-2 on D. So, sorry, this is 1-2 high 3. So it's kind of an intermediate level fingering. If you can't do that yet, then hold off on this. If you feel like you're ready to learn that, I have a video for that. I'm specifically teaching you raised third or high third. By the way, in the comments field below, I'll have some fingerings. I'll have links to other useful videos. So here's that A pentatonic, lower octave. And here's the next octave. And without moving our hand from first position, we can also add 3 and 4. Okay, so we got. So nice, so pretty, backwards. Two bows on the A major pentatonic. Let me do that again, slow, sorry. Excited and wanted to go fast. Okay, so I think that's good for this lesson. With these pentatonics, you can try out variations like rhythms. We did triplets. You could do hoedown. Any rhythm you can think of, swing. Try adding slurs, slur two. Slur two, separate two. So on. All right. Furthermore, if you are interested in improvising, you can use these as a first step. And you can improvise using what I call drone tracks that I keep posting. And basically, you can just experiment with a scale over a tone, kind of just a bed of, like, say you're doing it for the key of A major, have it just like this droning A note, and you just practice playing over it. And I actually have a video which explains how to kind of start using drone tracks, and I'll put a link to that below as well. All right, I think that's a good point to end this lesson. I'll probably do some more on the pentatonic, but I think that's a good amount of stuff for you to work with right now, okay? All right, I'll see you next time. So long.
Thanks for watching the video.
Excellent.